When the rain is blowing in your face and the whole world is on your case, I could offer you a warm embrace to make you feel my love.
Sandy was on a night out in Glasgow with Dan and a couple of other friends, and Rowan was on a night out with her sister Barry. Now, after chatting at the taxi rank for a while, they all decided to share a taxi into the centre of town and split the fare, and the rest of the night was spent together as a group. Sandy and Rowan got on really well and they swapped phone numbers. They spoke almost every day on the phone, and it took about a month for Rowan to pluck up the courage to meet up with Sandy again. If truth be told, Rowan very nearly backed out of meeting Sandy, and it was her mum who convinced her to go. Rowan remembers her saying, "You don't know where this might lead, and if you don't meet up with him, you will always wonder, what if?" So good words of encouragement there. And of course, Rowan is very glad that she took her mum's advice. So their first date was in Hamilton on a beautiful sunny day. Understandably, they were both really nervous, with Sandy talking non-stop and Rowan hardly saying a word. Rowan moved into Sandy's flat in Hamilton, and within 8 months of their first date, Rowan had fallen pregnant with Lily. So the couple moved to Stirling to be closer to both of their families for the much needed moral support during that exciting but scary time. When Lily arrived, healthy and perfect, of course, they were over the moon. But as all parents would agree, this was a testing time for the relationship. Now, Sandy organised a night away for the two of them without the girls, and they chose Glasgow because it was where they had first met. So Sandy spent the whole day wearing a tweed jacket, and Rowan got extremely annoyed with him because he was blatantly roasting alive, but refused to take the jacket off, which she assumed was because he was just being stubborn. Rowan, of course, didn't realise that he had the ring in his pocket and was paranoid that he was going to lose it or someone was going to steal it. He had got Rowan the ring that she had said that she'd wanted since they had first met. Sandy and Rowan, you are clearly meant to be together, and in embarking on your journey as a married couple, you will share your hopes and your dreams, your plans and adventures. Now, this handfast symbolises the strength of your love and commitment for one another. So the first knot is for Sandy's love for Rowan, and the second knot is for Rowan's love for Sandy. Now, Sandy and Rowan are now going to exchange their wedding rings, which have been warmed by all your thoughts, hopes and wishes for their marriage. These wedding rings stand as a symbol of your love for each other. The unbroken circle representing unending love, wholeness and peace. The circle, which is also a symbol of the sun, the earth, the changing seasons and the universe as a whole.
I give you this ring as a token of my enduring love and support.
I give you this ring as a token of my enduring love and support. Rowan, I promise to love you and to trust you, to be honest with you and be faithful to you. I promise to be a loving and supportive husband to you for as long as we each shall live.
Randy and Rowan, now that you have exchanged your vows of commitment and your wedding rings in the presence of your family, friends and witnesses, it is my very pleasant duty to pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss.
And I tell her every day.
Yeah, I know, when I compliment her, she won't believe me. It's so sad to think that she don't see what I see. But every time she asks me, do I look okay? I say, when I see your face, there's not a thing that change, 'cause you're amazing. Yeah. Just the way you are. And when you smile, the whole world stops and stands for a while. 'Cause girl, you're amazing. Just the way you them all day if she let me. Her laugh, she hates but I think it's so sexy. She's so beautiful, and I tell her every day. Oh, you know, I never ask you to change. It perfects what you're searching for, and just the same. So don't even bother asking babe. When I see your face, there's not a thing that I would change. 'Cause you're amazing, just the way you are. And when you smile, the whole world stops and stares for a while. 'Cause girl, you're amazing. Stops and stares for a while. 'Cause girl, you're amazing, just the way you are. Girl, you're amazing, just the way you
say she's crazy, she got diamonds on the soles of her shoes. Well, that's one way to lose these walking blues. Diamonds on the soles of your shoes. She was physically forgotten, but then she slipped into my pocket with my car keys. She said, "You've taken me for granted because I please you. Wearing these diamonds." And I could say, ooh, as if everybody knows what I'm talking about, as if everybody here would know exactly what I was talking about. I'm talking about diamonds on the soles of a shoe.
Ha ha ha! the sign of a wave. The poor boy changes clothes and puts on aftershave to compensate for his ordinary shoes. And she said, honey, take me dancing, but they ended up by sleeping in a doorway by the bodegas and the lights on over Broadway, wearing diamonds on the soles of their shoes. And I could say,
ooh, daddy.
Everybody, you know what I was talking about. I mean, everybody, you know exactly what I was talking about. I'm talking about
be someone who walks away so easily. I'm here to stay and make the difference I can make. Our differences, they do a lot to teach us how to use the tools and